Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here, chemistry PhD and fan of research-based skincare. Today I'm going to be talking about the science behind two very popular Neutrogena products, the Ultra Gentle Daily Cleanser and the Clear Pore Cleanser and Mask. I think there's this idea that picking the right cleanser is just about low pH, and these two are low pH, but there's a lot more to cleanser formulations than just that. This video is sponsored by Neutrogena, and I'm super grateful that they think my content is worth supporting. If you like nerding out about the science behind beauty products, make sure you subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Neutrogena's Ultra Gentle Daily Cleanser is one of my new favorite drugstore cleansers. It's a foaming cleanser, which is my favorite type, because it spreads over skin nicely and washes off easily. I know there's this common perception that foaming cleansers are harsh and stripping, and this comes from the fact that for a long time, the only ingredient that would foam really well was sodium lauryl sulfate. This ingredient is usually a bit on the harsher side unless you formulate with it very carefully, but in the last few decades, chemists have realized that you can blend together gentler ingredients and still get a really nice foam. So this cleanser, even though it foams really well, doesn't contain harsh surfactants. Surfactants are the cleaning ingredients in cleansers. This cleanser uses hydrophobically modified polymer technology, which was developed by scientists at Neutrogena. Generally, the harshest ingredients in a cleanser are the surfactants. Basically, this cleanser has ingredients that act like a little reservoir for the surfactants, so they're all cleaned together into one big mass. When it's clumped together, the surfactants actually foam better in the cleanser. The clump is also too big to get into skin and irritate it, and that means that it's actually gentler and less irritating than some non-foaming cleansers. But the surfactant molecules can still detach one by one from this clump, and so it still acts as an effective cleanser that gets rid of dirt and grease on your skin. So this doesn't have that harshness or stripping that you might expect from a cleanser that foams up and cleans skin effectively. This also has a ton of my favorite humectant ingredient, glycerin. Glycerin is really good at holding onto water, so it acts like a little sponge that sits on your skin and keeps it hydrated. This is particularly important in a cleanser because cleansing is generally the harshest step in a skincare routine. Wet skin is also more permeable, which means that during and after you cleanse, that's when your skin is most prone to dehydrating, and glycerin helps counteract this effect. This cleanser is lightly fragranced, the fragrance is hypoallergenic, and it doesn't contain any known allergens or essential oils. I really like how this cleanser doesn't strip my skin, and it leaves my skin feeling soft and smooth. My skin gets dehydrated really easily, especially right after I wash it, so it's really good to have a drugstore cleanser that keeps my skin hydrated and happy. It also comes in a pump, which is my favorite type of packaging. It makes it super convenient to use. The other product I'm talking about in this video is the Clear Pore Cleanser and Mask. This is a product that's designed to help with short contact therapy with benzoyl peroxide. It has 3.5% benzoyl peroxide. You can use this either as a regular cleanser, or you can put it on as a mask that you wash off after about 5 minutes. Benzoyl peroxide is a classic acne treatment, and it's so effective that it's usually regulated as a drug in most countries. It's been used for acne since the 1930s, and it works in a few different ways. I think most people know that it's antibacterial. It acts to kill the bacteria formerly known as Propionibacterium acnes, now called Cutibacterium acnes. These bacteria are one of the four contributing factors to acne, and it kills them in a way that doesn't cause bacterial resistance. It also acts on two more contributors to acne. It prevents clogged pores, and it reduces inflammation. A lot of people are sensitive to benzoyl peroxide. It causes irritation in up to 40% of people who use it. You might get redness, dryness, peeling, and stinging. Luckily, it looks like wash-off products with benzoyl peroxide work pretty well at treating acne, and it does it with less irritation. It works in a really short amount of time, so you don't have to leave it on your skin and have it irritate. There's also the bleaching issue. Benzoyl peroxide can break up dye molecules in fabric, so it can bleach patches on your clothes, pillowcases, and towels. This product washes off, so it's a lot less likely to happen, and it's particularly good for treating acne on your body because it's really hard to avoid getting that on your clothes. This also has glycerin as the second ingredient on the ingredients list, and that's really useful because it can counteract the drying effect of benzoyl peroxide. Most people will probably need to use a moisturizer afterwards anyway because benzoyl peroxide is quite harsh, and of course you need to wear a sunscreen as well. There's also kaolin and bentonite clay, which helps soak up oils, which deals with the fourth contributor to acne, which is excess oil production. It's actually the only clay mask that actively kills bacteria as well. I love how easily this spreads on my skin and washes off. My skin is oily and acne prone, but sometimes I find benzoyl peroxide still a bit too harsh because I'm also quite prone to dehydration, and my skin is sometimes a bit dry from using retinoids. If I want to use benzoyl peroxide without having an extra layer on my skin or that extra irritation, this is great. I usually put it on before I go into the shower or even in the shower, and then wash my hair and then wash it off. This cleanser does have menthol in it, which gives it that tingling or cooling effect, and it's probably my only complaint about this product, especially because I'm in Australia and we're heading into winter and I am cold enough. I do know that a lot of people like that refreshing feeling in their acne products. It's not bad for you, it's just a personal preference. And it is actually quite useful to tell if you've washed it off properly before you go and blot your face and get benzoyl peroxide everywhere. So that's my breakdown of those two Neutrogena products, the Ultra Gentle Daily Cleanser and the Clear Pore Cleanser Mask. I hope you found this video interesting. Let me know what you thought of these products if you've tried them before. Thanks again to Neutrogena for partnering with me. If you like videos on the science behind beauty products, you can click the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. You can also check out my blog, labmuffin.com, and follow me on Instagram at labmuffinbeautyscience for lots of little sciencey tidbits. See you next time for another sciencey beauty video.